Any more questions? All right, so I'm going to take it out to the public, and I think you were stepping up to answer Councilmember Craig's question.
Thank you, Mayor Pro Tem, members of the council. My name is John Bailey. I'm representing Mike Yassin, the owner of the property. And I would like to first thank staff for so quickly moving this project through the city. It was very important for the timing for the owner. Mike is in the auto business and has his finger on the pulse of the auto business and made the determination that in the near term, the auto business is not going to come back sufficient to have this property represented with an auto dealer. I believe it's I don't want to drop the name, but another auto dealer in that vicinity, a 25,000 square foot auto dealer, is now closed up and is empty. And so there's a vacant auto dealer in that area. There is no vacant retail in the area. I asked an esteemed colleague of mine, I have a project at the end of a long city council meeting and I can't discuss the details of the project. How do I convince the city council that it's a good project? And his advice was speak briefly and carry a site plan. So I have a site plan here that I would like to thank the city's economic development director for bringing this site plan user to us, and we've developed the site plan, and this is a real user that has real interest in the property. It's a user that I think every member of the city council would approve of. I believe that members in that local community, the auto dealers and the other retailers in the area, would see good synergy from this. I believe that this site is visible from 101. According to our architects, when it's built up, there would be enough for a sign, I guess, that you could see on 101. That's based on the architect's opinion. But you know, this is a real user. It's a little over 50,000 square feet, so it's less than the 72,000 square feet that's being asked for. What we had put in for the site plan amendment was maximum flexibility, so that Mr. Yaskin could go and find the right user for the site that would make a lot of sense with the other tenants in the area. So I don't know if that answers your question or not.
Is it one retailer?
This site plan is for one retailer with another little annex, but this is not an inked deal. So I'm not at liberty to disclose who the actual retailer is, and I'm not sure that this will actually go in. I believe it's a real deal. But what he wants to leave right now, or Mike has left, is the maximum flexibility. So what you're approving is a site plan amendment for 72,000 square feet. And obviously, we want to maximize the tax revenue that could be derived from that site, and 72,000 square feet was the right size to go as big as you could, but still allow maximum flexibility. But what the end user will be something less than 72,000 square feet. This site plan I'm holding is 50,200 with another 7,500 square foot pad, so I can't do the math in my head, but you know, under 60,000. But it's a real user, that would work with the site that I think would be good for the mix in the city, good for the city. I don't know if it'll pan out, you know. So all I can say is that I believe that this is a real opportunity, and I'd like to thank the city's economic development director for bringing it. Any other questions for me?
Any other questions, Councilmember McShane?
I can't help but want to think there's got to be a way to be more flexible, so that should there be the chance for an auto dealership or for retail, there be a way to go back. Or, I mean, maybe this is more of a question for our planning department, but you know,
they're going to think you're my shill because I've been working with them to make sure there is that flexibility, actually.
Yeah, I mean, that's got to be it. I mean, is this inked in stone and all of a sudden it's like, no,
it's
way,
not.
No how?
We have built flexibility into the plan that, and I'll let Mr. Grossman speak for himself, but basically the conversation we had is, as long as it's a new auto dealer, if this deal were to fall through and an auto dealer were to come forward that was a new auto dealer, we would still have flexibility to use it for that purpose. And I think
a new auto dealer as opposed to a used car.
Correct. No, used.
Dealer.
Used is not currently allowed, and the auto dealers that are there, I don't believe would want used in the vicinity.
So, okay.
And my client's perfectly fine to respect their wishes. So I think I'll let Courtney answer the specifics on that, unless someone else has another question for me.
Any other questions? Okay, seeing none. Courtney. You will answer a question.
Staff has been working on an alternative resolution. This resolution would provide the flexibility that Mr. Bailey was just referring to. It has not been distributed. It's still in draft form. Should the council be interested in such an endeavor, I could briefly describe how it would function, and perhaps if this is desirable, the council could direct staff to incorporate this language into the final resolution. What it would do essentially is pinpoint this site and allow, in the alternative of the retail proposed tonight, a new auto dealership subject to the auto dealership standards, which are contained on table 3 in the precise plan. And what this would allow is that if the retail project does not go forward, it would allow the flexibility of the auto dealership to come in place instead of. The reason for the new car sale restriction is that is the same restriction that applies to all other auto dealer sites in the original Phase 1 Auto Center and the two other auto dealer sites in the northern part of Bronda Crossing. Used car sales are only allowed or only permissible in conjunction with a new car dealership. And that's a ground rule that's been consistently applied to all the dealerships in the auto center.
Is there any questions for Courtney? Councilmember McShane.
Okay, given that we've got a plan, we don't know what's behind the curtain, and there is this alternative that isn't inkjet, what would be the right, obviously if there's nothing ready tonight, this would have to be tabled. Do you need a week, 10 days, 6 to 8 weeks? I mean, about how much time staff-wise, I mean, would this alternative take to be worked out? I guess that's the first question. Secondly, to what extent are you in touch with the Salinas auto dealers? Are they at the table? Are you guys all visiting as this is moving forward? Property owner, developer, Salinas auto dealers, et cetera?
Let me take the second question first. Staff has fielded a couple of phone calls from auto dealerships. There are concerns that we may hear tonight from them. Some of those concerns might involve traffic or our used car sales, perhaps. In terms of the actual resolution, I'd probably look for some concurrence of the city attorney, but staff could be provided with general direction by council to put together a resolution for final adoption and come back at another meeting or maybe put one together tonight. I think it really depends on the complexity as this meeting develops herein.
Thank you. That's cool.
Any other questions?
And I assume if I could just add a comment, Madam Mayor Pro Tem, I believe that all the notices for these changes have gone out in the normal routine way. Is that correct, Courtney?
Correct. There's posting on the site. There's the ad in the paper and the mailings on the 300-foot radius circulation list. The notices basically said there is a precise plan amendment. The specifics of that particular amendment were not included in the notice.
Okay. Councilmember Sanchez.
Just on the traffic and the concerns with traffic, retail would generate more vehicle traffic, right?
Correct. There's a greater demand in traffic.
So, I mean, and so is there any, I know there's no crystal ball, but is there any way to anticipate, does that affect possibly the auto dealers there, or do they come and shop and go away and then become a traffic problem for people coming to look at cars? I mean, as we study and look at that, was that an issue, and what do we find out?
We have the traffic engineer that prepared the traffic analysis in the audience, and I'm not sure what calculation was used on pass-by trips and whatnot, but that answer can easily be.
And also if we can talk about other experiences and what other auto dealers have maybe faced when retail gets injected into the same areas, and how does that affect that, possibly or negatively? Because if they're coming to shop and also buy a car, it's good, but if they're just coming to shop, then they become a problem to others coming to just shop for cars.
Yeah, I think the traffic engineer can provide some information in that regard.
Engineer.
Good evening, Gary Black with Hexagon Transportation Consultants. We did the traffic study for the project, and yes, the retail generates more traffic than an auto dealership, and a complete traffic study was done to update the EIR and to look at the traffic volumes on the streets in that area to make sure that they would comply with the city standard with the retail use on the site instead of an auto dealer. And that was the purpose of the traffic study, that concluded that the city's operating standards would be met at all the surrounding streets.
So if it becomes a retail space, did the study take in consideration pedestrian traffic? Because if you have retail, then you're going to have people, seniors or people without vehicles, using public transportation, and you have that kind of traffic coming in there. So how does that affect, or does that reduce the amount of traffic? I'm just trying to picture what the analysis and what a...
Well, there's already a great deal of retail in that center, and this would be an addition to that. So the infrastructure to serve the people that would come, other than driving, is already put in place, and this would add some pedestrian connections as well for connections from this particular site into the rest of the center and also to the bus stops. I don't know if that answers your question, or
so you don't anticipate major changes to the traffic circulation there, because you already have a little bit of a backup for people trying to turn into the auto center right in front of the store. So is there recommended changes to that, because you already have a little bit of a bottleneck there coming from Baranda this way?
We're not recommending any changes generally in the traffic study, though I can say that a lot of times backups are a result of the particular timing of the signals, and if your city traffic engineering department sees that there's backups on a particular leg of the intersection, they can make adjustments to the timing of the signal and reduce those backups, and that's routinely done. You know, over time, as things change, traffic patterns change, then the adjustments can be made to how the signals operate. But just in general, does the system have the capacity to accommodate retail? Yes, it does. That's what our study was looking at.
Thanks. Okay. I need to conclude council member questions, and I need to take it out to the public. Is there any other questions? Okay, seeing none, I'm taking it out to the public now. Is there any questions on this item or comments, public comments?
I'd like to make one real brief comment. As far as the idea of tabling this, we do have a real user that is waiting for the answer from the city council, so I definitely would not want to table this. As far as the my legal opinion, as far as the auto use, being able to go back to auto use, was that you could go back to auto use without adding that extra language. That was more a courtesy that Courtney had felt it would be clear to add that language in there so that it was clear to everyone on the table. But if you think about it, if you did nothing today, it would be allowed for auto use. So I don't legally know to allow that to continue as a result of what's going on today, how that's changing anything to add that language. But my preference would be to not add the language, take it as is compared to tabling it. But clearly, if the city would prefer to have that language in there and we could have that language in there today, then I'd prefer to go with that option. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Tom Mayer from My Dealerships. We have three dealerships in the Salinas Auto Center, which I would like to say, in my opinion, the Salinas Auto Center is one of the finest auto centers in the state of California. The city of Seaside, which I also have two properties there, just spent approximately $24 million trying to get cars off the road into the dealership and improve the appearance of the Salinas Auto dealership, Auto Center. If you go into Gilroy now, you'll see all of the employees on street parking. It's just a mess. And we've really got something to be proud of there. I'm sorry I missed the planning meeting.